precious night, a memorable night, a night in which the Savior has come unto us. So today we have this celebration of this Holy Eucharist as a thanksgiving to infant Jesus, thanksgiving to baby Jesus, offered by the following members. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Richard Manjula. Thanksgiving Mass to Mother Mary, offered by Anita and Celine Anthony. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Jacqueline, David and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Jesus for all the blessings, offered by Jacqueline, David and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Virginia Lobo and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Jesus for all the blessings, offered by Edna and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Noel, Cecilia and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Jesus and Mother Mary on the birthday of Aaron and Elena, offered by Edna, Sebastian and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Angelina and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Angelo and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Sunny and Mary. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by MVM, Michael and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Diwakar and Vanita. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Robert and Mary and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Michael and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Jesus, offered by Francina, Pascal and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Mother Mary, offered by Vincent Raj and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Gerard Pascal and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by G.P. Venkatesh and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Vijaya Mary, Kalpana. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Mrs. Leonie Martin and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Delphina and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by S. Devaraj and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Almighty God, offered by John Ambrose and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Holy Family, offered by Neeta Amrutraj and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Chata Alexander and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Jesus, offered by A. Magdalena Mary. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Avinash and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Joseph Anthony and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Tasicia and family. Thanksgiving Mass to baby Jesus, offered by Gomes Manuel and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Bitti Matai and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus for special blessings, offered by Ambrose and family. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Tumma Mary. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Janardhan and Monica. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Dundi Reddy, Sunita. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by S. Rami Reddy. Thanksgiving Mass to Infant Jesus, offered by Gadimath Sudhan Reddy and family. May the good Lord accept all these thanksgivings and then bless the families who have offered these masses. And very special way, the Lord may bless Aaron and Elena on the occasion of the birthday. Kindly rise.
Whispering,
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen. And with your spirit.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Vandanam.
Yeshua
Stotram.
Tandri Deva Stotram.
Atma Deva Stotram.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Dear friends in Christ, Christmas celebration without Jesus, it is empty. Christian life without Jesus, it is meaningless. Jesus is born for us to give us the true peace, true joy, true happiness. Jesus' birth represents, symbolizes universal salvation, light of the world for the whole humanity. Jesus' birth brings for the world the true peace, true joy, true happiness. He is the only one who is the Prince of Peace. He is the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. That is why first reading Prophet Isaiah, he tells the people of Israel, the God is going to be born for us. He brings us salvation. The gospel tells us Jesus is the Prince of Peace for whom we have been waiting. He is a Prince of Joy. He is a Prince of Love. ఈ లోకంలో ఎందరో మహానుభావులు జన్మించారు, మహాపురుషులని పేరుగాంచారు, చెప్పుకున్నారు. నేను దూతనని చెప్పుకున్నాడు, రాజులని చెప్పుకున్నారు, నన్ను అనుసరించమని చెప్పుకున్నారు. కానీ యేసు ప్రభు ఒక్కరే మళ్ళీ తిరిగి జీవంతో లేచారు. యేసు ప్రభు ఒక్కరు మాత్రమే మన హృదయాల్లో జన్మించడానికి సిద్ధంగా ఉన్నారు. Therefore, let us invite Jesus into our hearts, into our minds, into our life as our true peace and joy. In case we fail, let us ask the Lord His pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask to blessed Mary, a virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May the Almighty God have mercy and forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Jesus, who is born in the night. And when we sing Gloria, it is the time that the Lord Jesus is amidst us. While the Gloria is being sung, bells will be rung, and we will also bless the baby Jesus. And after the completion of the Gloria, we will place the baby Jesus in the crib that was made specially for him.
Let us pray. O God, who gladden us year by year as we wait in hope for our redemption, grant that just as we joyfully welcome your only begotten Son as our Redeemer, we may also merit to face him confidently when he comes again as our Judge, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
First reading, a reading from the book of prophet Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 to 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in a land of deep darkness, on them has light shone. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy, they rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as they are glad when they divide the spoil. For the yoke of his burden and the staff for his shoulder, the rod of his oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For every boot of the tramping warrior in battle tumult and every garment rolled in blood will be burned as fuel for the fire. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace, there will be no end on the throne of David and over his kingdom to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Sun is shining. Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus, chapter 2, verses 11 to 14. இரண்டாம் வாசகம் தீத்துவுக்கு எழுதிய திருமுகம் அதிகாரம் 2 இறைவசனங்கள் 11 14. ஏனெனில் மனிதர் அனைவருக்கும் மீட்பராம் கடவுளின் அருள் வெளிப்பட்டுள்ளது. நாம் இறைப்பற்றின்மையையும் உலகை சார்ந்த தீய நாட்டங்களையும் மறுத்து கட்டுப்பாட்டுடனும் நேர்மையுடனும் இறைப்பற்றுடனும் இம்மையில் வாழ இவ்வருளால் பயிற்சி பெறுகிறோம். மகிழ்ச்சியோடு எதிர்நோக்கியிருப்பது நிறைவேறும் என காத்திருக்கிறோம். நம் பெருமிக்க கடவுளும் மீட்பரும் ஆகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவின் மாட்சி வெளிப்பட போகிறது. அவர் நம்மை எல்லா நெருக்கடிகளிலிருந்தும் மீட்டு நற்செயல்களில் ஆர்வமுள்ள தமக்குரிய மக்களாக தூய்மைப்படுத்த தம்மையே ஒப்படைத்தார். இது ஆண்டவர் வழங்கும் அருள்வாக்கு.
Kindly rise for the gospel acclamation.
Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment when Quirinius was governor of Syria, and all went to be enrolled, each to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the city of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to be delivered, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in a swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in that region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. And the angel said to them, "Be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy, which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David, who is Christ the Lord, and this will be a sign for you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men with whom he is pleased. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
The words of the Gospel bring us everlasting life. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
యేసువ వందనం, యేసువ స్తోత్రం, తండ్రి దేవ స్తోత్రం, ఆత్మదేవ స్తోత్రం. హల్లెలూయా. ప్రైజ్ ది లార్డ్. ప్రైజ్ ది లార్డ్. ప్రైజ్ ది లార్డ్. డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఇన్ క్రైస్ట్, క్రిస్మస్ బ్రింగ్స్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్ true peace and true joy, true happiness. It brings equality for everyone, brotherliness, togetherness. Every community will come to the Lord. As in the introduction we heard, Christmas without Jesus is empty. A Christian life without Jesus Christ, that is in our life, it is meaningless. Which means that the Christmas has to carry the spirit of Christmas, which means that we need to have within us Jesus himself. True peace, true joy. Jesus, as he brought us true peace and joy for every human person, for the whole humanity, for the universal salvation. As a salvation for everyone. That's why prophet Isaiah, he speaks about the person who is going to be born. He'll be the King of Kings. He will bring salvation to everyone. And the people of Israel, they were not listening. But still, the people were waiting. Somehow, God will send a person. We know very well, there were so many prophets were sent to this earth. So many judges, the minor prophets, major prophets, and so on and so forth. Finally, Jesus was sent to this earth. If you read St. John chapter 3 verse 16, it's very clear there. God the Father has sent Jesus to be born as a human person. He loved the so much the world, he sent his only son for us. To save all of us from our sinfulness, from Satan, and so on. But Jesus, let us be happy and joyful as Jesus is born for us, for our salvation. And the second reading tells us clearly, St. Paul, he speaks about you have to remove ungodliness. By the grace of God, Jesus is given for us. As for our salvation. And the gospel, if we just hear and intrinsically, internally, if you understood that, Jesus is the Prince of Peace. The people were waiting for him, that is born for us, to give us true joy and true happiness. That's why birth of Jesus brings throughout the world true peace and goodness. ఈ లోకంలో యేసు ప్రభు యొక్క జననము శాంతిని, శుభాన్ని చేకూర్చింది. శాంతి అనే మన హృదయంలో తండ్రి అయిన దేవుడు క్రీస్తు ప్రభు ద్వారా నింపాడు. The birth of Jesus is the light of the world for the salvation of the humanity. The light of the world for the humanity. And it shows that everybody has to live in love, in joy, in peace, and in happiness. I remember a few centuries ago in Japan, there was a custom. Old parents, they were sent to the thick forest, and the children have to leave that old parent, maybe father or mother, they have to leave and come in the forest. And one such old parent, she was a very pious woman. She's very aged, more than 90 years. And the son doesn't want her to leave in the forest. Because there was a custom that the son has to take her and put her in the thick forest. And she could not walk. He put her on his shoulder and then he was going through the forest. She was having the knife in her hand. And as the son was taking her, that is to forward, she was cutting the branches and going along the way. Finally reached the thick forest. And he has to leave her there and come back. And the mother was telling the child, the son, go safely. God is with you. Mommy, I noticed that you were cutting the branches on the way. And the mother's reply was, you shall not miss the way. That is why I have created the way. Wherever the branches are there, you see the branches and you just go back to the house. Otherwise, you'll be missed in the thick forest. And then he thought that my mother showed me love, such a love. And he hugged her. No, mommy, I will take you back. Doesn't matter. You come with me. Then finally, he took her back and went to the particular village in Japan. And all the elders of the particular village, they were saying, why you left? Why you brought her back? You should have left her there. No, I will not leave her. She did like this, like that. Then finally, everybody understood that particular custom has to be stopped. We cannot leave the old parents in the thick forest. She might be, you know, in danger, might be eaten by all the wild animals. Then that custom was stopped. And we could see that God loves us. The mother loved the son so much. That's why if you read Isaiah 49 verse 15 and 16, the Lord says, I will not forget you. Mother will not forget a sucking child. In case mother forgets, but I will not forget. That's what the Lord is telling. Which means that God, he will love us more than the mother loving the child. దేవుని యొక్క ప్రేమ ఎటువంటిదంటే 100 రెట్లు తల్లి తన పసికందుని ప్రేమిస్తుంది అంతకంటే 100 రెట్లు దేవుడు మనల్ని ప్రేమిస్తాడు, దీవిస్తాడు, ఆశీర్వదిస్తాడు, మనల్ని ముందుకు నడుపుతూ ఉంటాడు. ఎందుకంటే దేవుడు మనల్ని ఎన్నుకున్నాడు. క్రీస్తు ప్రభు ఈ లోకంలో జన్మింపజేశాడు మన కోసం, మనలో శాంతి నింపటానికి, సమాధానం దయచేయటానికి, తన శక్తి నింపటానికి. అందుకోసం ఎవరైతే దేవాది దేవుణ్ణి విశ్వసిస్తారో వారు దండిగా దీవింపబడతారు అని. యేసు ప్రభు ఈ లోకానికి వచ్చింది వెలుగుని ఇవ్వటానికి. అందుకో యోహాను సువార్త 8:12 ప్రభు అంటున్నారు, ఈ లోకమునకు వెలుగును నేనే, నన్ను అనుసరించువాడు ఎప్పుడు వెలుగునందు పయనిస్తాడు. ఐఎమ్ ద లైట్ ఆఫ్ ద వరల్డ్, హూఎవర్ ఫాలోస్ మీ విల్ హ్యావ్ ద లైట్ ఆఫ్ లైఫ్. అందుకోసమే తండ్రి అయిన దేవుడు మనలో నిండుగా తన జీవాన్ని ఇవ్వటానికి ఈ లోకంలో తన కుమారుని లోకానికి పంపాడు. అందుకోసం ప్రభు అంటున్నారు చూడండి, సెయింట్ జాన్ చాప్టర్ 10 వర్స్ 10, ఐ హావ్ కమ్ టు దిస్ వరల్డ్ టు గివ్ యూ లైఫ్ ఇన్ అబండెన్స్. జీసస్ ఈజ్ ఇమ్మాన్యుయల్, ఈజ్ విత్ అస్. హౌ డు వీ ఫైండ్ దట్ ఈజ్ విత్ అస్? దోస్ హూ హ్యావ్ ఫెయిత్ ఇన్ గాడ్, దే విల్ కమ్ టు నో దట్ ద ప్రెజెన్స్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్ ఇన్ దే లైఫ్. వెన్ వీ రియలీ రియలైజ్ జీసస్ ఈజ్ విత్ అస్, విల్ బి ఆల్వేస్ సక్సెస్ఫుల్, ఈవెన్ ఇన్ ద మిడ్స్ట్ ఆఫ్ అఫ్లిక్షన్స్, ఇన్ ద మిడ్స్ట్ ఆఫ్ ట్రబుల్స్ అండ్ ట్రయల్స్ అండ్ ట్రిబులేషన్స్, విల్ బి ఆల్ ద టైమ్ విన్నింగ్, విల్ బి సక్సెస్ఫుల్. ద ట్రబుల్స్ విల్ కమ్ ఆన్ అవర్ వే, బట్ వీ విల్ బి బోల్డ్ ఎనఫ్ టు ఫేస్ దెమ్. మనలో కష్ట నష్టాలు, వేదనలు, శోధనలు, బాధలు అన్నీ వస్తుంటాయి, అయినా కూడా వాటిని ఎదుర్కొంటాం. ఎందుకు? దేవుని యొక్క ఉనికి, దైవ సన్నిధి మన యందు ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి. కాబట్టి ఈ యొక్క క్రిస్మస్, ఈ మిడ్ నైట్ మాస్లో, ఈ దివ్య పూజ బలిలో ప్రభు మనల్ని అందరినీ దీవించాలని మనము ప్రార్థించాలి. క్రీస్తు ప్రభు బెత్లెహేము నగరంలో జన్మించారు, అది ఆ టైంలో జరిగింది, కానీ ఇప్పుడు మన హృదయాల్లో జన్మించాలి. అది ఎలా జరుగుతుంది? ఎప్పుడైతే మనము పూర్తిగా విశ్వసిస్తామో, దేవునికి ప్రథమ స్థానాన్ని ఇస్తామో, వెన్ వీ మేక్ జీసస్ యాజ్ సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ లైఫ్, వెన్ వీ మేక్ జీసస్ యాజ్ ద సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ లైఫ్, హీ విల్ గివ్ అస్ ద లైట్, హీ విల్ గైడ్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ అస్ ఆన్ ద రైట్ పాత్, హీ విల్ బ్లెస్ అస్ అబండెంట్లీ. దట్ ఈస్ వై వీ హ్యావ్ టు బీ అలర్ట్ అండ్ యాక్టివ్. యూ హ్యావ్ టు ప్రే ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ డే, యూ హ్యావ్ టు కీప్ ఆన్ ప్రేయింగ్, కీప్ ఆన్ థ్యాంకింగ్ గాడ్, కీప్ ఆన్ ప్రైజింగ్ గాడ్, అండ్ దే బై వీ విల్ హ్యావ్ ద లైట్ ఆఫ్ లైఫ్. వీ హ్యావ్ జీసస్ హిమ్సెల్ఫ్ ఇన్ అవర్ హార్ట్స్. జీసస్, వెన్ వీ రియలీ యాక్సెప్ట్ జీసస్ యాజ్ అ పర్సనల్ సేవియర్, వెన్ వీ గివ్ ప్రయారిటీ టు ద లార్డ్, వెన్ వీ యాక్సెప్ట్ జీసస్ సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ లైఫ్, వీ విల్ బి ఆల్వేస్ థింక్ గుడ్, విల్ బి ఆల్వేస్ యాక్ట్ గుడ్. మనము మంచినే తలస్తాం, మంచినే చేస్తుంటాం, మంచినే స్థాపిస్తాం, మంచి అనేది జరిగేలా చూస్తాం. మంచిని స్థాపించి ఇతరులకు కూడా మంచే జరగాలి, నాకు జరగాలి, నీకు జరగాలి, ప్రతి ఒక్కరికి జరగాలని మనము కోరుకుంటాం. అంటే వీ హ్యావ్ టు అవాయిడ్ ఈవిల్, డూ గుడ్, అవాయిడ్ ఈవిల్. ప్రొఫెట్ ఐజాయా చాప్టర్ 1 వర్స్ 16 అండ్ 17 స్పీక్, డూ గుడ్ అండ్ అవాయిడ్ ఈవిల్, మంచిని చేయండి, చెడును విసర్జించండి అని. ఏ విధంగా మనము ముందుకు వెళ్తాం? ప్రభువుని మనం కనుగొంటాం. ప్రభు ఏమంటున్నారు? మీరు మంచిని చేసినప్పుడు, శాంతి శాంతి కలిగి జీవిస్తూ ఉన్నప్పుడు, ప్రేమతో జీవిస్తున్నప్పుడు నేను మీ అందు ఉంటాను. దట్ ఈస్ ద కింగ్డమ్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్, అది దేవుని రాజ్యం, దేవుని యొక్క విలువలు, డివైన్ వాల్యూస్ ఆఫ్ లైఫ్. ద వాల్యూస్ ఆఫ్ లైఫ్ ఆర్ ప్రేమ, కరుణ, శాంతి, సమాధానం, ఆనందం. వీటిని మనము ఎప్పుడు కూడా జ్ఞప్తి అందించుకొని ఈ యొక్క విలువలను మనము జీవించాలి, అప్పుడే మనము దండిగా దీవింపబడతాం. ద గుడ్ షెపర్డ్స్, ద షెపర్డ్స్ వే టోల్డ్ బై ది ఏంజల్, గో టు ద మేంజర్ అండ్ సీ దే, అండ్ దే ఫౌండ్ ద లార్డ్, ద చైల్డ్ ఇన్ ద మేంజర్. దే స్టార్టెడ్ వర్షిపింగ్ ఆఫ్టర్ గివింగ్ ద గిఫ్ట్స్. వాట్ ఎవర్ గిఫ్ట్స్ దే వే గివింగ్, దే వే గివింగ్ ఓన్లీ వాట్ ఎవర్ దే హ్యాడ్, యు నో, ద గోట్స్, maybe sheep, maybe the bed sheet or the sticks and so on. They gave the gifts they offered. What type of gifts that we can offer? The good deeds, the good works, the good intentions, our love, our kindness, our compassion, encouragement to the people. We can offer the gifts to the people, and to the Lord we have to surrender our life. Manam tyaganto manchi viswasanto, గట్టి విశ్వాసంతో మనకై మనము దేవునికి అర్పించుకోవాలి. అదే బిగ్గెస్ట్ గిఫ్ట్, దేవునికి అర్పించాలి. ఇతరులకు మనము శాంతితో ఉండాలి. కరుణ, ప్రేమ, దయ, శాంతము, వీటితో మనము జీవించాలి. దైవీక విలువలు మనం జీవించడానికి సిద్ధంగా ఉన్నామా? ఒకసారి మనం ఆలోచించుదాం. ప్రేమకు, శాంతికి, సమాధానానికి మనమే సాక్ష్యం. మనము సాక్షులంగా జీవించాలి. యాక్ట్స్ ది అపోస్టిల్ చాప్టర్ 1 వర్స్ 8, అపోస్తుల కార్యాల్లో 1వ అధ్యాయం 8వ వచనంలో ప్రభు ఈ విధంగా పలుకుతున్నారు, మీరు నాకు సాక్షులుగా జీవించాలి, ప్రేమ, శాంతి, సమాధానం, కరుణ, దయ వీటన్నిటి విలువలు మీరు జీవిస్తున్నట్టయితే, విలువలు కలిగి జీవిస్తున్నట్టయితే నాకు సాక్ష్యమిచ్చినట్టే. వెన్ యూ లివ్ ఇన్ పీస్, లవ్ అండ్ జాయ్ అండ్ హ్యాపీనెస్, ఎంకరేజ్మెంట్, అప్రిసియేషన్, కైండ్నెస్ అండ్ కంపాషన్, వెన్ యూ అక్సెప్ట్ ది అదర్, వెన్ ఎంకరేజ్ ది అదర్, విచ్ మీన్స్ దట్ యు ఆర్ గివింగ్ లైఫ్ ఫిట్నెస్. లెట్ అస్ సీ దట్ టు నైట్ కెన్ వీ డిసైడ్ దట్ జీసస్ టు బీ ఆ సెంటర్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ లైఫ్, దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు గివ్ ప్రయారిటీ టు ద లార్డ్ బికాస్ ఈజ్ ఆర్ సల్వేషన్, ఈజ్ బాన్ ఫర్ అస్ యాజ్ అ ప్రిన్స్ ఆఫ్ పీస్. హీ బ్రాట్ అస్ ద పీస్, జాయ్ అండ్ హ్యాపీనెస్. And he stands for universal salvation, the light of the world for humanity. And Jesus, he stands for love, mercy, forgiveness, compassion. He is the redeemer of the world. He is the savior of the world. He showed us the way. He showed us the truth. He showed us the life, the way of life, way of truth, way of joy and peace. Therefore, let us follow. Devudu manaku manchi margam chupincharu. ఏ విధంగా జీవించాలి, ఇతరుల ప్రేమ, శాంతి, సమాధానాలతో నీవు ఏ విధంగా జీవిస్తావు, ఏ మార్గంలో నువ్వు పయనించాలి. ఎందుకంటే ప్రభు ఆ మార్గంలో వెళ్ళారు కాబట్టి ఆ మార్గంలో మనం కూడా వెళ్ళాలి అని ప్రభు మనల్ని కోరుతున్నారు. కాబట్టి యొక్క దివ్య పూజ బలిలో మనము నిండుగా మనకై మనము యేసు ప్రభువుకి సమర్పించుకుందాం. దివ్యబాల యేసు ఎప్పుడు కూడా మన యందు ఉండాలని మనం ప్రార్థించుదాం. Let the child Jesus be in our hearts, be born in our hearts, so that we may live the divine values of life with peace, love and joy. Amen.
இறை இயேசுவில் பிரியமான அன்பு சகோதர சகோதரிகளே, இந்த இனிமையான அமைதியான இரவிலே, மார்கழி மாத குளிரிலே பிறந்த நம் அன்பு இயேசு குழந்தையின் பிறப்பு விழா வாழ்த்துக்களை உங்கள் அனைவருக்கும் தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறேன். விஷ் யூ ஹாப்பி கிறிஸ்மஸ் டு ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ. இறை இயேசுவில் பிரியமானவர்களே, இந்த உலகத்திலே ஒரு ஜீவன் ஒரு நாள் இன்பத்திற்கு 9 மாதங்கள் கஷ்டத்தை அனுபவிக்கின்றது. ஒரு நாள் இன்பத்திற்கு 9 மாதங்கள் கஷ்டத்தை அனுபவிக்கின்றது என்றால் அந்த ஜீவன் நம்மை பெற்றெடுத்த அன்பு தாயானவள் ஒருவள் மட்டும்தான். எண்ணி பாருங்கள், ஒரு நாள் இன்பம் அதுதான் நம்முடைய பிறப்பு. அந்த பிறப்பிற்காக 9 மாதம் நம்மளை தன்னுடைய வயிற்றிலே சுமந்து அனைத்து கஷ்டங்களையும் துன்பங்களையும் ஏற்று அந்த ஒரு நாள் இன்பத்திற்காக 9 மாதங்கள் கஷ்டப்படுகிறார். அன்னை மரியாலும் இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவை இந்த உலகிற்கு கொண்டு வர, உண்மையான மகிழ்ச்சியை இந்த உலகத்திற்கு கொண்டு வர, உண்மையான ஒளியை இந்த உலகிற்கு கொண்டு வர அன்னை மரியால் 9 மாதங்கள் எல்லா விதமான கஷ்டங்களையும் துன்பங்களையும் அனுபவித்து இதோ இந்த இனிமையான அமைதியான இரவிலே நம் அன்பு மகன் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து பிறந்திருக்கின்றார். அன்பாந்தவர்களே, இந்த கிறிஸ்மஸ்ன்னு சொன்ன உடனே எனக்கு ஒரு நிகழ்வு ஞாபகம் வருது. பூனோவில் படிச்சுட்டு இருக்கிறப்போ செமி கிறிஸ்மஸ், கிறிஸ்மஸ்க்கு என்ன பண்ணுவோம், நம்ம சின்ன பசங்களை வச்சு கிறிஸ்மஸ் ஒரு ஸ்கிட்டு போடுவோம், ட்ராமா போடுவோம். அதுக்கு யார் ட்ரைனிங் கொடுப்பாங்கன்னு பார்த்தோன்னாக்கா சிஸ்டர்ஸ் தான் ட்ரைனிங் கொடுப்பாங்க, எல்லாம் சின்ன சின்ன பசங்க. அப்படி ட்ரைனிங் கொடுத்தப்போ ஸ்கிட்டு நடக்குது. என்னன்னாக்கா யோசேப்பும் மரியாவும் 4 வீடுகளில் சென்று கதவை தட்டி எங்களுக்கு இடம் வேணும் அப்படின்ட்டு கேட்கணும். உடனே அந்த 4 சிறுவர்கள், ஒவ்வொரு வீட்டில் இருக்கின்ற ஒவ்வொரு சிறுவர்கள் என்ன சொல்லணுனாக்கா, இங்கே இடம் இல்லை போ அப்படின்னு சொல்லணும். ஸோ அன்னை மரியாள் தன்னுடைய வயிற்று வலியை அந்த வலியை தாங்க முடியாமல் ஒரு பக்கம் அவள் நின்று கொண்டிருக்கின்றாள். மறுபக்கம் யோசேப்பு சென்று முதல் வீட்டு கதவை தட்டுகிறார். தட்டின உடனே உடனே அந்த குழந்தை கதவு திறந்து இங்கே இடம் இல்லை போ அப்படின்னு சொல்லிடுச்சு. ஏன்னா சிஸ்டருங்க ட்ரைனிங் கொடுத்ததால அப்படியே எப்படி ட்ரைனிங் கொடுத்தாங்களோ அதே மாதிரியே சொல்லுதுங்க பசங்க. ஸோ உடனே யோசப் என்ன பண்ணுறாரு, சரி இப்படி சொல்லிட்டாரு அப்படின்ட்டு ரெண்டாவது வீட்டுக்கு வராரு. ரெண்டாவது வீட்டுக்கு வந்தோடனே அங்கேயே கதவை தட்டி கேட்குறாரு. அவரு என்ன சொல்கிறார், அந்த சின்ன குழந்தை இங்கே இடம் இல்லை போ அப்படின்ட்டு கெட்டியாக கத்துறது அந்த குழந்தை. உடனே மூன்றாவது வீட்டுக்கு வருகிறார். இந்த மூன்றாவது வீட்டுக்கு வந்த உடனே அந்த குழந்தை கதவை திறந்து இங்கே இடம் இல்லை போ அடுத்த வீட்டுக்கு போ அப்படின்னு சொல்லிடுச்சு. உடனே யோசேப்புக்கு மூன்று வீட்லேயும் கேட்ட உடனே அவருக்கு ரொம்ப மன கஷ்டம். ரொம்ப மன கஷ்டத்தில் என்ன பண்ணுறதுன்னு தெரியாமல் மரியாவை கூட்டிக்கின்னு நாலாவது வீட்டுக்கு கதவை தட்டுற போகிறதுக்கு முன்னாடி இந்த மூணாவது வீட்டில் குழந்தை உடனே வெளியே வந்து யோசேப்பு ரொம்ப கஷ்டப்படுறதை பார்த்துட்டு சிஸ்டர் தான் இப்படி சொல்ல சொன்னாங்க ஸ்கிட்டில், ஆனால் எங்கள் வீட்டில் இடம் இருக்குது, இந்த ஸ்கிட்டு முடிஞ்சவொடனே நீங்கள் வாங்க, எங்கள் வீட்டு மாடியில் இடம் இருக்குது, உங்களுக்கு இடம் தரேன் அப்படி என்று அந்த குழந்தை மிக அருமையாக சொன்னது. அன்பாந்தவர்களே, சிறு குழந்தைகளிடமிருந்து தான் இந்த உண்மையான பகிர்வு, உண்மையான அன்பு, உண்மையான மகிழ்ச்சி என்ன என்பதை நாம் கற்றுக்கொள்கின்றோம். ஆம் அன்பாந்தவர்களே, கடவுள் தன்மையில் இருந்த இறைவன் இந்த உலகிற்கு மனிதனாக பிறக்கின்றார். எப்படி? கடவுள் தன்மையில் இருந்த இறைவன் இந்த உலகில் தன்னை வெளிப்படுத்த மனிதனாக பிறக்கின்றார். மனிதன் கடவுளாக மாற நினைத்தான், மாற முடியவில்லை. அதுதான் தொடக்க நூலிலே பார்க்கின்றோம். கடவுள் இந்த பழத்தை சாப்பிட வேண்டாம் என்கிறார். ஆனால் அதை சாப்பிட்டுவிட்டு மனிதர்கள் கடவுளாக மாற வேண்டும் என்று எண்ணிக்கொண்டு பாவம் செய்தார்கள். கடவுள் அவர்களை விட்டுவிடவில்லை. மாறாக தன்னுடைய அன்பை வெளிப்படுத்த, தன்னுடைய உண்மையான மகிழ்ச்சியை மக்களுக்கு வெளிப்படுத்த கடவுள் மனிதராக இந்த உலகத்தில் பிறக்கின்றார். அன்பாந்தவர்களே, எந்த ஒரு கடவுளும் எந்த ஒரு மனிதனும் இந்த மாதிரி நிலைமைக்கு தள்ளப்பட மாட்டார்கள். எந்த ஒரு கடவுளும் இந்த மாதிரி நிலைமைக்கு வரமாட்டார்கள். கடவுள் மனித நிலையை எடுத்துக்கொண்டு இந்த உலகத்திலே பிறப்பதற்கு. ஆகவே அன்பாந்தவர்களே, கடவுள் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து தன்னுடைய அன்பை வெளிப்படுத்த தீவன தொட்டியில் பிறக்கின்றார். தீவன தொட்டி என்பது மாடுகள் சாப்பிட்ற ஒரு உணவை வைக்கிற அந்த ஒரு தொட்டி. அந்த தொட்டியில் பிறக்கின்றார். ஒரு 75 வருடங்களுக்கு முன்பு காந்தியடிகள் இவ்வாறு சொன்னார், உண்மையில் இறைவன் மறுபடியும் இந்த உலகிற்கு வர வேண்டும் என்றால் அவர் ஒரு ரொட்டி துண்டாகத்தான் வர வேண்டும். எப்படி? ஒரு ரொட்டி துண்டாகத்தான் வர வேண்டும். எதற்காக என்றால், இந்தியாவிலே 75 வருடங்களுக்கு முன்பு இந்தியா மிகவும் வறுமையில் வாடிக்கொண்டிருந்தது. அப்பொழுது காந்தியடிகள் இவ்வாறு சொல்கிறார், இறைவன் இந்த உலகிற்கு மீண்டும் வர வேண்டும் என்றால் அவர் ஒரு ரொட்டி துண்டாகத்தான் வர வேண்டும். ஆனால் 2000 ஆண்டுகளுக்கு முன்பு ஆண்டவர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து இந்த உலகிற்கு, இந்த மனிதர்களுக்கு, நம் அனைவருக்குமே ஒரு ரொட்டி துண்டாக தீவன தொட்டியிலே அவர் பிறந்தார். என்ன ஒரு சந்தோஷமான செய்தி, என்ன ஒரு சந்தோஷமான ஒரு அற்புதம். கடவுள் மனிதனாக பிறக்கின்றார். அந்த மனிதனாக பிறக்கின்ற கடவுள் வெறும் மனிதராக மட்டும் இல்லாமல் நம் அனைவருக்குமே ஒரு உணவாக நம்ம தன்னையே கையளித்தார். ஆகவே அன்பாந்தவர்களே, இன்றைய காலகட்டத்திலே நாம் எண்ணி பார்க்கின்ற பொழுது கடவுள் இந்த உலகத்திலே மீண்டும் வர வேண்டும் என்றால் ஒரு மருத்துவராகவோ ஒரு செவிலியராகவோ தான் பிறக்க வேண்டும். ஏனென்றால் இன்று கடந்த 2 வருடங்களாக இந்த கொரோனா தொற்று நோயினாலும் புது வைரஸ் ஒமிக்ரான் வைரஸ், இன்னும் எத்தனை வைரஸ் வரும்னு தெரில நம்மளுக்கு. ஆனால் வருகின்ற இந்த நாட்களிலே உண்மையில் கடவுள் பிறக்க வேண்டும் என்றால் ஒரு மருத்துவராகத்தான் பிறக்க வேண்டும். ஆனால் ஏற்கனவே இயேசு கிறிஸ்து ஒரு மருத்துவராக அன்று பிறந்தார். நற்செய்தியில் பார்க்குறோம், செவிலர்களுக்கு காது கொடுத்தது, கேட்பதை கொடுத்ததும், கண் தெரியாதவர்களுக்கு கண் பார்வையும், நடக்க முடியாதவர்களுக்கு நடப்பதற்கும் இப்படி என்று தன்னை ஒரு மருத்துவராக அவர் மக்களுக்கு வெளிப்படுத்தினார். ஆகவே அன்பாந்தவர்களே, இந்த கிறிஸ்து பிறப்பு விழா நாம் கொண்டாடுகின்ற இந்த நன்னாளிலே நாம் அனைவரும் ஒரு உண்மையை தெரிந்து கொள்ள வேண்டும். இயேசு கிறிஸ்து 2000 ஆண்டுகளுக்கு முன்பு பிறந்த பொழுது இப்படி ரொம்ப டெக்கரேஷன் எல்லாம் பண்ணி அவர் அங்கே பிறக்கலை. ஒரு ஏழ்மையான குடிலிலே தான் பிறக்கின்றார். நம்ம சர்ச்சை என்ன தான் டெக்கரேஷன் பண்ணாலும் கடைசியாக அந்த குடிலுன்னு வரப்போ பார்த்தீங்கன்னாக்கா அங்கே எப்போவுமே ஒரு ஏழ்மையான ஒரு குடிலை தான் நாம் பார்க்குறோம். யாரும் பில்டிங்கில் ஜீசஸ் கிரைஸ்ட்டை பிறக்கிற மாதிரி யாரும் வைக்க மாட்டாங்க. ஒரு குடிலிலே ஒரு ஏழ்மையாக பிறக்கின்றார் என்பதை தான் நமக்கு வெளிப்படுத்துகின்றது. அன்பார்ந்தவர்களே, இது எதை உணர்த்துகிறது என்றால், நாம் ஏழ்மையாக இருக்கலாம், எளியோராக இருக்கலாம், ஆனால் ஆண்டவர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து நம்முடைய மனதிலே பிறக்க வேண்டும், நம்முடைய மனதிலே பிறக்க வேண்டும். இன்றைய நற்செய்தி வாசகத்திலே பார்க்கின்றோம், ஆண்டவர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்துனுடைய பிறப்பு பணக்காரர்களுக்கோ அரசர்களுக்கோ யாருக்கும் அறிவிக்கப்படவில்லை. முதன் முதலாக இடையர்களுக்கு, ஆட்டுக்குட்டிகளை மேய்ச்சிருக்கிற இடையர்களுக்கு தான் அறிவிக்கப்பட்டது. இந்த இடையர்கள் அவர்கள் அந்த சமுதாயத்திலே ஒரு கெட்டவர்களாகவும் எளியவர்களாகவும் கருதப்பட்டார்கள். அப்படிப்பட்ட மக்களுக்கு தான் இந்த இயேசு கிறிஸ்துனுடைய பிறப்பு செய்தி முதன் முதலாக அறிவிக்கப்படுகின்றது. ஆகவே அன்பார்ந்தவர்களே, இயேசு கிறிஸ்து யாருடைய உள்ளம் ஏழ்மையாக இருக்கின்றதோ, யாருடைய உள்ளம் ஆண்டவரை தேடுகின்றதோ, அவருடைய உள்ளத்தில் மட்டும்தான் ஆண்டவர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து பிறப்பார். ஆகவே இந்த எளிமையான கிறிஸ்துமஸ் விழாவினை கொண்டாட நாம் அனைவரும் முற்பட வேண்டும். அன்பார்ந்தவர்களே, இயேசு கிறிஸ்து தனக்கு இடம் கொடுக்கவில்லையே, தன்னை ஏமாற்றி விட்டார்களே என்று, தன்னை ஏற்றுக்கொள்ள மறுத்து விட்டார்களே என்று அவர் பழி வாங்காமல் இறுதியில் இந்த மானிட மக்களுக்காக தன்னையே முழுமையாக கையளித்தார், தன்னையே முழுமையாக கையளித்தார், உணவாக கையளித்தார். ஆகவே அன்பார்ந்தவர்களே, இந்த கிறிஸ்து பிறப்பு விழாவினை கொண்டாடுகின்ற நாம் அனைவருமே ஒரு எளிமையான முறையிலே நாம் கொண்டாட வேண்டும். ஒரு ஆடம்பரமான வாழ்க்கையை வாழாமல், ஒரு ஆடம்பரமான விழாவை போல் கொண்டாடாமல், அப்படி கொண்டாடினாலும் நாம் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து எப்படி பிறந்தார், எதற்காக பிறந்தார் என்பதை உணர்ந்து செயல்படுகின்ற பொழுது அதுதான் உண்மையான கிறிஸ்துமஸ். ஆகவே அன்பார்ந்தவர்களே, பிறருக்காக தன்னையே கையளித்து நம் அனைவரையும் பாவத்திலிருந்து மீட்டார். அதே போலத்தான் நாமும் நம்மையே மற்றவர்களுக்காக அர்ப்பணித்து, நாமும் நம்மையே கடவுளுக்கு அர்ப்பணித்து மற்றவர்களுக்காக வாழ்ந்து, நம்மையே பிறருக்கு உதவி செய்யும் நபர்களாக மாற்றிக்கொண்டு இந்த கிறிஸ்து பிறப்பு விழாவை ஒரு மிக மகிழ்ச்சியான முறையிலே நாம் கொண்டாட முற்படுவோம். அன்பார்ந்தவர்களே, இந்த கிறிஸ்து பிறப்பு விழாவினை கொண்டாடுகின்ற நாம் அனைவருமே மகிழ்ச்சியை மட்டுமே விதைக்க வேண்டும், அன்பை மட்டுமே கொடுப்போம். அப்பொழுதுதான் ஆண்டவர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து நம்முடைய உள்ளத்திலே பிறப்பார். ஆண்டவர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து நம்முடைய உள்ளத்திலும் நம்முடைய இல்லத்திலும் பிறக்க வேண்டுமென்றால் நம்முடைய இதயம் தூய்மையாக இருக்க வேண்டும். நம்முடைய இதயம் தூய்மையாக இருக்க வேண்டுமென்றால் முதன் முதலாக நாம் ஏழ்மையாக இருக்க வேண்டும். ஆகவே நம்மையே நாம் தாழ்த்தி கொண்டு, எவ்வாறு கடவுள் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து தன்னையே தாழ்த்தி கொண்டு ஒரு ஏழ்மையான குடிலில் பிறந்தாரோ, அதே போல நாமும் நம்மையே தாழ்த்தி கொண்டு ஆண்டவர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்துக்கு நம்மையே அர்ப்பணித்து வாழ்கின்ற பொழுது, அப்பொழுது உண்மையிலே ஆண்டவர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து நம்முடைய இதயத்திலும் நம்முடைய உள்ளத்திலும் நம்முடைய இல்லத்திலும் பிறப்பார். ஆகவே அன்பார்ந்தவர்களே, உங்கள் அனைவருக்கும் மீண்டும் ஒருமுறை கிறிஸ்து பிறப்பு விழா வாழ்த்துக்களை தெரிவித்து கொண்டு, அனைவரும் மகிழ்ச்சியோடு கிறிஸ்து பிறப்பு விழாவினை கொண்டாட வேண்டும் என்றும் இறை ஆசிரியை நீங்கள் பெற்றுக்கொண்டு, உங்களையும் உங்கள் குடும்பத்தையும் இறைவன் நிறைவாக ஆசீர்வதிப்பாராக. ஆமீன்.
Kindly stand all of you. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and was buried. He descended into hell.
On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us elevate our hearts and minds to God, who has come among us as a little child. Worship him with a true devotion and make to him our prayers in faith and trust. Our response: be with us and keep us faithful to you, O Lord.
Be with us and keep us faithful to you, O Lord.
That the Pope, the bishops, the priests, the religious, and the laity may with pure hearts and holy hands embrace the Lord who comes, remain in his love, and proclaim to the world the salvation he brings. We pray to the Lord.
Be with us and keep us faithful to you, O Lord.
That we may learn to appreciate and to love the Lord at his coming to us, and learn to welcome joyfully his promise of light and life. We pray to the Lord.
Be with us and keep us faithful to you, O Lord.
That in the midst of the cares, worries, and troubles of our daily life, and amidst the struggle for avoiding evil and doing good, we may know how to receive with exultant joy the mystery of the Incarnation. We pray to the Lord.
Be with us and keep us faithful to you, O Lord.
That we may recognize ourselves as beneficiaries of the event of Christmas, as its witness and as the poor in heart who have awaited the long-desired Savior. We pray to the Lord.
Be with us and keep us faithful to you, O Lord.
That the faith in God who became man may enable us to discover in every circumstance a word of comfort, light, peace, and joy to the brothers and sisters who need them. We pray to the Lord.
Be with us and keep us faithful to you, O Lord.
Let us pray for our personal needs. Let us pray. Father in heaven, grant that the joy we experience tonight as we celebrate the coming of your Son as our Savior may never be lost from our hearts, and that we may be zealous communicators of this joy to all those with whom we love and work. We make this prayer through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Pray defense that all sacrifice may be accepted to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
As we look forward, O Lord, to the coming festivities, may we serve you all the more eagerly, for knowing that in them you make manifest the beginnings of our redemption. Through Jesus Christ, O Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with the angels, archangels, with thrones and dominion, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory. You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples and said, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples and said, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all, so the sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and bread of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Paul Anthony, our Bishop, and Tummabala, Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her most dear spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced with eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
With heaven, him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, grant peace and joy in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with the holy will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace and joy of the Lord be with you always. And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold whom takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who call to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
With joy, let's prepare to receive Jesus who have come unto us, mainly to forgive our sins and to show us way back to God our Father. Two priests will be coming first to the top area. Give space for Father, the side, and then follow one behind the other. Those who are sitting down can also come straight in two rows. Receive the communion and then go back your way. And after receiving, sit in your place and then reflect. Don't be in a hurry. All will be receiving communion. Let's maintain a little bit of discipline and respect to Jesus.
Thank you.
Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O good Jesus, hear me. Within thy wounds, hide me. Suffer me not to be separated from you. From the malignant enemy, defend me. And at the hour of my death, call me and bid me come to you, that we praise you for all eternity. Amen. Today is the first birthday of twins Aaron and Elena, whose parents and grandparents joyfully are providing the Christmas cake piece to each and every one of us. While we pray to these two little ones, God's blessings may be upon them forever and ever. If we go spiritually, we have four Gospels: Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And if we look for the directions, we have four: north, south, east, and west. And if you are traveling, you have four ways: one, airways; second, road; third, sea; and the fourth one, walking. In order to celebrate the presence of Lord amidst us, loving people of God, to fix all these arrangements for this day, also four different groups of our parish have rendered their service. The first one, parish priest and the assistant. The second one, the sisters of Vincent Nilayam. The third one, the council members or the area representatives. And the fourth one, entire community of St. Anthony Church, Venkatapuram. Nobody to be excluded and nobody to be separated. It is the hard work and planning of each and every one of us doing their best, starting from the little child till the grown-up, and then who is not even able to walk or not even able to get up. At least by their prayers, definitely they have supported for this grand celebration of this Christmas. So I would like to take this occasion, while I brought to your mind that if someone feels that I have not done anything for the church, while going you can switch off one light and go. All have done something or the other, that is the wonder of it and the speciality of it. So I acknowledge the service of everyone in whatever the way that you wanted to express. Now, already it's late, and then to begin to mention the names will be difficult. But still, I say, when I said from the little ones to the elders who are not able to even get up and then walk, they prayed. The little ones, in their own way, by their appearance, by their presence, have done wonderfully well. So while thanking Father Jayaraj for having come here to celebrate this Christmas Mass and then to bring down God's blessings upon each and every one of us. I also take again this occasion to thank all the four different communities who have really done wonderful work, hard work, hours together somehow spent, and then made this day a great day of pleasing for us. May Babe Jesus, who is with full of peace, joy and love, give you all the same and make you all rejoice. I take this occasion to wish you all a happy Christmas and the blessings of God and the peace, love and joy of Babe Jesus amidst us. Wish you all a happy Christmas. Thank you. God have blessed us. We could have a wonderful service in spite of questions and then doubts. Let's also keep up again the COVID norms, keeping in mind the rising of Omicron. Still maintain the distance and then be safe to yourself. Keep others safe. Use mask always and sanitize. Let's be in peace and joy. Are our leaders distributing the cake? Yeah. Why can sing a hymn in the meantime, a small hymn? And the cake is being distributed. Only one announcement. The announcement is, tomorrow is a Sunday, again day of obligation to attend Mass. So do not forget, Sunday Mass as usual we have 6 o'clock Tamil and 7:30 Telugu and 9 o'clock English, that's Sunday. But today morning we have again 7 o'clock Tamil Mass and 8:15 Telugu Mass, 9:30 English Mass, and no evening Mass on 25th, that is this day.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we may draw near vigor from celebrating the nativity of your only begotten Son, by whose heavenly mystery we receive both food and drink, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God of infinite goodness, who by the incarnation of his Son has driven darkness from the world, and by that glorious birth has illumined this most holy night and day, drive far from you the darkness of vice and illumine your hearts with the light of virtue.
Amen. Amen.
May God, who willed that the great joy of his Son's saving birth be announced to shepherds by the angel, fill your minds with the gladness he gives and make you heralds of his gospel.
Amen. Amen.
May God, who by the incarnation brought together the earthly and heavenly realm, fill you with the gift of his peace and favor and make you sharers with the church in heaven.
Amen.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.